Good afternoon. Welcome to Daily Currency Update from the Currency Desk. On Wednesday morning, we had a strong opening for the US dollar vis-a-vis the Indian rupee. This was mainly attributed to the fact that we had a few positive economic data from the US economy, which were in the form of US durable goods overnight. Also, we saw the USD index strengthening in the international markets on Wednesday morning, due to which we had a strong opening for the US dollar. Later in the day, as the day progressed, we saw the INR stop its downfall near lifetime lows. This was mainly being attributed to the fact that there were fears that the RBI might intervene near 60 levels. But yes, in the evening session, as we had a dovish statement from the European Central Bank President Mario Draghi stating a few dovish statements, we saw the euro and the other risk on currencies fall, taking the Indian rupee for a downside along with them. Based on this, we had the USD INR rate cross above 60 at the spot for the first time, and once it crossed above 60 levels, we saw a sharp rally in the Indian rupee up till in the US dollar up till 60.72 levels. This was mainly being attributed to the month end buying by importers of US dollar, and at the same time also there were a lot of huge positions which are rumored to have hit their stop losses at near the lifetime high levels. Today in the morning, we had a strong opening for the Indian rupee vis-a-vis the US dollar, and this was mainly because of the strong current account deficit data that we saw. The current account deficit in the quarter 4 has improved to around 3.5% from a high of 6.7% in the previous quarter. The quarter 4 current account deficit is at $18 billion as compared to a $32 billion deficit in the quarter 3. This is a huge positive, as because the recent negative expectations in the Indian rupee or the fall in the Indian rupee were mainly because of the fears of a steep rise in the current account deficit. But since the current account deficit has actually improved, we can actually expect some correction in the US dollar value in the near days. Coming to euro, the euro pair was holding strong against the Indian rupee, but the gains were capped because the euro USD rate was falling. This fall in the euro USD rate was also because of the dovish statements made by the ECB president Mario Draghi. Later in the day, as we had a lower than expected GDP data from the US economy, we saw the euro cover some of its losses intraday. In the near term, we can expect the euro INR rate to correct, but yes, it all depends on the US data outcomes in the near days and also based on the USD INR pair movement. The pound was largely strong against the Indian rupee, gaining sharply because it had strengthened against the US dollar as well in the international markets. But yes, as we had positive data from the US economy, we saw the pound also depreciate in value. What also added to the weakness in the pound was the Bank of England's Financial Stability Report, which stated that the euro area crisis could affect the progress of the UK economy as well, and its current slowdown could be lengthened to a certain extent. Based on this, since the pound is trading at lifetime high levels against the Indian rupee, we could expect the pound to correct from current levels. Coming to Japanese yen, the Japanese yen is largely sideways against the US dollar and the Indian rupee. In the near term, we could see appreciation in the value of Japanese yen. there has been reports of the current prime minister winning a majority in the upper house by a huge margin, and if such a thing happens, it is expected that there might not be that much focus on policy reforms or on continuing to grow the third largest economy in the world. So based on this, we saw the Japanese yen fall in value, but yes, in the near term, the movement in Japanese yen would be on the upside, but it would be advisable not to long Japanese yen against the Indian rupee, as we could expect a sharp rebound for the Indian rupee in the near term. Thank you.